on 105 FM and online.
Brace yourself! It's Andy Snowden, stage and stage and stage and screen!
Go ahead, make my day.
Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce me.
And you will know my name is the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon thee.
You ever seen a grown man naked?
Here's Johnny.
Life is a box of chocolates, almost. You never know what you're gonna get.
Tell me about it, Stir.
Stage and screen!
So, on Monday of this week, just happened to be April the 1st, there was an incredible story that was all over social media and all over the media as well, and the BBC. It was the story of the All Saints School in Gresford, who on Monday morning everyone turned up to the school to find a spaceship had crash-landed on the school field. Now, many geniuses, as you would imagine, many geniuses across Wrexham cried that it was an April Fool's joke. But the teacher, Matt Holmes, said it was completely coincidental that that happened on April the 1st. All the children arrived on Monday morning to see that a UFO had crashed, and there was paramedics and ambulances on standby to treat anybody, and there was police taping off the field. And as I say, the media were there as well. It was all brilliantly executed by the staff of the school, including, the ambulance service, which was, it was an out-of-service ambulance, I've been told to say, and a police officer as well, who was on annual leave. I've got to say that as well, because so many people moan. God, you'd be amazed how many people complain about things like this. Anyway, so the police officer, on annual leave, let's not forget this, got up early to add to the proceedings. It was brilliant. So I popped up there, just have a little nose, see what was going on, and I caught a word with six of the pupils at the All Saints School. And I've got to say, the astonishing knowledge from these children after just one morning studying of a UFO was what they didn't know wasn't worth knowing. Anyway, I was up there, and this is what happened.
I've just arrived at the All Saints School in Gresford, and you can probably hear in the background there's lots of commotion and lots of excitement from the children. And that's because this morning it seems that what can only be described as a UFO has actually landed on the playground, actually on the playing field. I'm looking at it now, it looks about the shape of what you'd expect a flying saucer to look like, with a light on top, and scattered around there are springs and other bits and bobs that have obviously fallen off. I'm going to go into the school now and have a chat with some of the children, see what they think about it all.
Well, in the infants' field, a flying saucer has crashed in there.
Yeah.
And aliens came out, and they're with the government right now.
Right.
And they're being looked after.
That's quite exciting, isn't it?
Yeah, because we had police and scientists and NASA here before.
NASA came?
Yeah. They left codes for us to uncode.
And have you worked that out yet? Or didn't
Yeah, but we can't pronounce the planet that they came from.
Yeah, it's like Staliland, isn't it?
Yeah, Staliland.
Yeah.
Staliland. Yeah. Fantastic. So when you came into school this morning?
Yeah. Mum thought it was like a big gust of wind that blew tons of things around, but it wasn't. It was the spaceship. Like making a big bang and sending everything flying.
And who told you that what had happened?
Well, a police lady came in while we were in assembly, because we were all standing across the line on the junior yard because we couldn't go into the entrance yard because the police was cornering it off because it has, like, there's engines and springs scattered everywhere.
Yeah, I saw that.
I think most of them will come off the spaceship.
Are you interested in spaceships and things?
Yeah.
Yeah, are you?
Yeah, definitely. I think we could give them one of our backup or us, because I'm sure we have a dwarf planet in one of them, because they came from a dwarf planet. It would be in the Goldilocks zone of the star, the backup us.
No, a backup what? Us.
Yeah, us.
Yeah, you taught me something there. I didn't know that.
So when we came into school, we all had to stand behind a line. It's because all the fields is taped off because like it's a little spaceship that has crashed into the school fields, and there's lots of like little things that have come out of it and stuff.
And what have you been told that's come out of it?
Aliens.
Aliens have come out of it. You know what they look like?
No, they just told us that they were smaller than us, but then they had the same skin colour as us, the scientists said.
And are they clever?
We don't know.
Don't know, we don't know anything about them.
Before the scientists got here, the paramedics had taken them away, so the scientists didn't see them either.
Oh, right. Well, one thing's for sure, they're not very good at driving, are they? Because they've made a bit of a mess in your playground there, haven't they?
Yeah, they knocked down a tree as well.
Have they? I didn't notice that. I didn't see the tree. So where do you think it's come from then?
Probably space.
Whereabouts? One of the planets?
Yeah, we got some clues from them, and then we got a letter which Miss Davis found on the yard, and then it came up with, because they use a different language from us, it came up with a symbol, and then you had to look above the symbol and then find out which letter it was and figure out the sentences.
Mr. Shimura had texts from Australia, and they had aliens in Australia as well.
Alright.
And the scientists said that they've had this happen in America as well.
Yeah. Well, you expect it in America.
Yeah.
You don't expect it in Gresford.
At night as well, so.
Yeah, my friend Ted said that he heard a big explosion, and the police officer who came in said she heard a bang. And right. Miss Davis, but she said she didn't really bother getting up because she didn't think it was like something to be worried about.
So you think it's come over here, over from the football field, and then sort of just crash landed into the field there?
Yeah.
Right.
So everyone came in, there were scientists over here as well. And we were all queuing up here because we were wondering what was going on. And we stayed here for a while watching them. And then we went back inside, and then at service they told us a little bit what was going on. Like some aliens have come in or something.
Yeah.
And they have crash landed here, but we're all safe and everything. And we figured out some codes that the teachers have set for us to figure out something, but that's all really. I think it's like a 3 or 4 digit code, which we need to figure out to open it.
So the when you came in this morning, that was the first you heard of it. You didn't hear of anything last night or anything?
No. People down there said that they heard a big bang at like 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
And they think that was it, but they don't know for sure.
And nothing's come out of it?
No.
As far as you
NASA
know.
Came this morning and they found something, but we don't know what it is because they can't tell us.
Oh, that'll be interesting.
Apparently
sure
the green, they're like little like us, but like little, like small,
tiny.
Like
yeah.
Tiny people, same colour and everything, and like look similar,
right.
But they're like really small.
So have you been working about this all day then? Is that...
Yeah, yeah. So as soon as we came in, we went to service, and then after that, we've just been working on it all day. And I think now we're going to like do something about it, like a presentation or something about it.
Right.
I'm not sure, but I think that's what we're doing.
Well, it's quite exciting, isn't it? I can't imagine you've ever really seen anything like this before.
When I woke up today, I didn't think I was going to see aliens.
No.
Calling occupants of interplanetary craft.
So there you go. What an absolutely fantastic thing to happen to the school kids of the All Saints School in Gresford. I've got Kim from the Kickstarter show in the studio with me, and she said all we did was go to the baths in Buckley. That's all we did as well. Absolutely fantastic. It was work based on problem solving, and the whole school has been doing a 2-week project based on aliens, and all their work is going to be displayed on next Friday for all the parents. Last day of term. Have a lovely Easter, everybody. Have a lovely, lovely Easter. Coming up on the Stage and Screen Show, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be hearing from the original Atomic Kitten herself, Miss Kelly Katona, as she goes round the country in The Beauty and the Beast. Easter pantomimes, they're big, aren't they? They're big these days. I don't know why. It's a money-making exercise, Andy. It's a money-making exercise. This is the Stage and Screen Show, ladies and gentlemen, and you are more than welcome to it.
It's the Andy Snowden Radio Show, show. It's the Andy Snowden Radio Show, show. It's the Andy Snowden Radio Show, show. It's the Andy Snowden Radio Show, show, show.